Ayua, I welcome you to Erin TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through Geography Form 2, lesson number 7. The topic it is internal learning forming processes. I'm your tutor, Lucy Mudoni. Welcome. We first of all look at the lesson goals. And our lesson goals today, we define the term folding, and also we look at the processes of folding. Let's start by looking at the definition. Folding is the bending of the earth crust due to the earth movement. So when the earth moves, remember we said the earth moves in three ways. It can move towards one another, it can move away from one another, or also it can move parallel past one another. So when now moving of this rock, it is towards one another, it causes the rock to bend. And that is what we refer to it as folding. When now it moves towards one another, that means the force that is applied here, it is the compressional force. It occurs mainly in sedimentary rocks when they are still in a semi-elastic state. This means that these rocks are very young. So they can be changed or they can be caused to bend even with a slight force. That is the reason why the folding takes place in the young sedimentary rocks. Let us look at the folding still definition. During the folding, rocks are bent upwards and downwards. So you get that when the rocks are crumbled or when they bend, they are caused to move upward and others downwards. The upfolds are referred to as the anticlines, while the downfolds are referred to as the synclines. So we have the anticlines and the synclines. The top part of the mountain, or that top part of the anticline, the topmost part of the anticline, we refer to it as the crest, while the bottommost part, we refer to it as the trough. The axis is the central line in the fold, from which the rock layers dip. So that central line gives us a bit, either in the anticline or even synclines, it gives us the axis. In the anticline or form which the rock layers lies in opposing directions as in synclines. Let us look at this part. We have already defined them. What is a limb? What is the axis? You can be able to see them. What is the synclines and also the anticline? You can be able to see them. So when we talk about the axis, it is that part that is indicated on the diagram there. You can be able to see all those things that we have discussed about. We have talked about the limb. We have talked about the anticline, synclines, and the axis, and the other. The limb of a fold is the layer of the rock on either of the axes. So you have already seen the limb, and that is the way we are defining it. It is the fold that is on one of the axes, either side of the axes, is the one that we refer to it as the limb. Now let us go to the processes, how it is formed, how folding takes place. Folding will take place when young sedimentary rocks are subjected to the compression force. So these young sedimentary rocks are supposed to have been subjected to the compression force. The rocks bend upward, forming the upfolds, and downwards, forming the downfolds. So these downfolds, we said that in case now there is a depression or it is extensive, it is large enough, it forms a depression, the downfolds that are referred to the geosyncline. So there must be first the formation of the geosyncline on the surface. And this is formed when now the sedimentary rocks are subjected to the compression force. We have the upfolds and the downfolds. The downfalls, when they are great enough, they form a depression, which we refer to it as the geosyncline. The geosyncline is filled with water to form a sea. So you happen to get that depression, it is filled by the surface line of water that gives us a sea. The surrounding land masses are eroded, and a resultant material is deposited in the geosyncline in layers. That means that as erosion is taking place, the surface runoff that is drained into the geosyncline, it is carrying that deposit with it. So this deposit, it is the one that is deposited in the geosyncline, and it is in it. The accumulation and weight of the deposited material causes the flow to subside further. So it causes now the flow to sink further. That is the subsidence. Further subsidence of the geosyncline triggers of compression forces. Now, as the geosyncline now, the one that has been filled in the deposit, subsidizes, it triggers the compression force. And remember the compression force, how it causes. It causes the crumbling or the bedding of the young sedimentary rocks that have already been formed. The layers of the sediment in the geosyncline are folded, bedding up and forming a mountain. So that is how the process takes place. You can be able to see, first we have the geosyncline. The geosyncline is filled with the water to form the sea, layers are there. We have the folding taking place, forming the fold mountains. Activity for today, explain the process of the folding with the aid of diagrams. That is the activity. For more information, you can go to the KRB 2003 Secondary Geography Student Book 2, that edition. If at all you want to contact us for more information, you can get us through the SMS. You can also get us through the YouTube. You can also get us through the Facebook. And also you can tweet at us. Otherwise, stay tuned to the LMTV. Thank you.